I met the psych major once who worked with babies. Or not babies, toddlers really. Ages 1 to 3, she said. She was telling me about this thing she learned about called object permanence. This idea that as babies, we gradually learn that things out of our sight don't cease to exist. We just can't see or hear them anymore. But they still exist, you just can't see them. That's why they love peekaboo. Things vanish and then reappear like it's nobody's business. It's like the best fucking magic show you'll ever see. But I guess as you get older, the magic part wears off, and it just becomes another part of life. You meet people and you remember them as you pass on the subway. You know that deli around the corner is still there to sell you cigarettes when you run out. But it's a lot of information to keep track of. Maybe that's why everyone is so tired all the time. There's just so much to remember. Too much sometimes. And if you ask me, it's not even like things really stay the same. Like this deli I used to buy my cigs from. One day I go in to buy some Newports, and what do I find? No fucking Newports. Man decided he don't want to sell Newports anymore. Something about how they have like glass in them. I had never heard about this glass business. So I started to go somewhere else. But I already know what's gonna happen. That'll change too. Eventually. And then I'll have to find somewhere else to go. Object permanence hasn't made much sense to me lately. Things don't last.
I don't know my place. I got people waiting on me. Stood up, I can't show my face. I got people hating on me. Mad that I control my fate. No, shit. Yeah, I can't show my face. Everywhere like I don't know my place. I got people waiting on me. Still though, I can't show my face. I got people hating on me. Mad that I control my fate. Damn. Shit though, I can't show my face. Yeah, I can't show my face. Yeah, I can't show my face. Okay now, putting stones into place now. What comes with a fake smile? These leaves come, got a rake now. Please tell me how you hate. I can see the thieves coming to the plate, swinging for the fruit, clinging to the taste. See me at the root, getting to the pain. I don't see the truth, I don't see the game. King to the booth, put me in the game. Same, same shit, pushing with the blame. Maintain shit, sitting on the wave. Maintain shit. Everywhere like I don't know my place, cause I can't finish what I started. I get locked inside my place. Pick a day when I get caught up, shit get bottled. I don't say, just a part of what you call an artist. Dying for the cake, goddamn. Everywhere like I don't know my place. I got people waiting on me. Still though, I can't show my face. I got people hating on me. Mad that I control my fate. Nah, shit. Yeah, I can't show my face. Yeah, I can't show my face. Yeah, I can't show my face.
North and south, like I don't know which way. I got spirits weighing on me, know that they gon' clear the way. All this sorrow in my body, like the spliff and clear the haze. Now, shit. Yeah, like I can't show my face. Yeah, every day watch my emotions change. And I know with heaven's grace I make my way with ease across the plain. As far as I can see, I just ain't the same. Me oh my, look at auntie face, she in her 70s. Papa cried when he told her how much it was hurting him. Feel despised by your family.
I don't really fuck with God like that, but if he's real, I hope my dog's in heaven. There's no doubt in my mind he'd make the cut. Everyone loved him. He was such a good...
Hey, you ever go to church? Sorry, what? I know you. You're the guy, right? Don't worry, I'm not a cop. think I'm bum a cigarette? Jesus loves you, unless, of course, you do drugs or have sex or be gay or any of the above, really.
Church.
Here we go.
No, not really. I don't think they like me if that's when we do that.
It's fair. I don't think they like me much either. At least definitely not anymore. I used to go a lot. Sometimes I wonder if I listened more, you know? Things would turn out better for me. But it just never really made sense to me.
So your parents were religious?
Yeah, well, my mother was. You know, she would wake us up Sunday morning, get ready, get the good shoes, slacks, all that. My daddy didn't care so much. You know, some days on Sunday, I'd fake him sick. Me and my dad would go out to basketball courts. It was right there by Columbus. We'd play basketball. Sometimes my mom would catch us and I'd get an earful from her, but it was always worth it. You know, my dad would buy me ice cream or pizza or, you know, something every time. It was good. It was simple. Nice.
Sounds like you had a good relationship with your dad.
Yeah, I guess. I did, anyways. I mean, things sort of went downhill from there. I'm sorry, am I oversharing? You know, people tell me I do that a lot.
Well, you already started. Feel free to continue.
I mean, then he met somebody new, and he left us. Started a new family, you know. It's too different from my mother. Just no way to work around it. And I guess he wasn't the worst father. He still came to visit me for some time after the divorce. But I resented him, you know. Sometimes I felt guilty and wondered, what if it was my fault? But mostly I was just angry. I just thought, how could you? The last time I ever saw him, I told him I hated him, that he was pathetic, that he let us down. I told him to never come see us again. And he never did.
No one could blame you for that.
Of course not. I mean, he was an asshole for leaving us. A couple months ago, though, he passed. Heart failure. Runs in the family or something. His new family invited me to the funeral. I didn't want to go. I get it, right? I don't want to go. What's the point? I mean, sometimes I wonder, what if I didn't say all that, you know? What if I try to learn his side of the situation, his story? Maybe then things would have been better. Anyway, it's too late now. But
right now. Anyways, you're the guy, right? You have everything? Can you give me something to help me sleep tonight?
Oh shit, it's the man. You're just the person I wanted to see. There's a big function going on tonight. Everybody's gonna be there, we're celebrating. Plenty of customers for you. You should come. We should go together. We should go to this function.
You sure you're good?
Oh yeah, hell yeah, man. I'm chilling.
You sure you're good?
Yeah, man, I'm fucking great. You want some soju? Can I bum a cigarette?
Yeah, I like it.
Fucking done, man. So what's up?
my piss, alright? Music kind of sucks, huh? Like, this shit is kind of trash. Like, something I listen to when I take a shit, maybe, or like, I don't know, like, drying my clothes in the morning, some thinking shit, you know?
What do you mean thinking shit?
You know, like something you listen to in the shower, or like you fucking sit in your cubicle and typing up words all day. Something you do when you think, like, yeah, you drive your kids to school in the morning, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like music that makes you think.
Yeah, but... I'm at the fucking function. I'm not trying to listen to music and think and listen to music and... You know, it's just memory. Like, what am I gonna eat for lunch? What am I gonna eat for dinner? Who am I gonna see this weekend? Like, how am I gonna get home? It's just memory to anxiety, and you know, like, when does it fucking stop? Like, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean?
I mean, sure, but you can't just stop thinking, right? Like, you can't just listen to music 24/7.
Yeah, but it's not about the music, you know? Like, that's... Were you even listening?
I mean, I thought I was.
It's just about something to get my brain to shut up for a second. You know, like, hard-ass 808s, pretty girl I'm talking to, whatever the fuck I'm gonna buy from you in about 45 minutes. Just about anything, man, you know?
It sounds like you know exactly what you need, then.
No, I don't. That's why I keep fucking trying the new shit out. Because the old shit gets boring so fucking fast. It's like, you know, I try one thing out, I try the next thing out, and it's like, what the fuck is after that? What's next?
Yeah. I mean, you know, like...
But what can I do, you know? Like, am I just gonna sit here and fucking sulk? Like, fuck that. You're not even listening, man. Like, actually, you know, could I buy me a cigarette? Man, fuck this. Like, I'm all up in my head. I'm gonna go somewhere that plays better music. You know? Hey, before I leave, let me get something fun for the road, dog.
I used to despise parties. I don't mind them too much now, though. Not that I like them or anything. Just used to them. You get used to anything after enough time. At least that's what I tell people when they come to me with their problems. People love coming to me with their issues, their hopes and dreams, their worries and fears. I'm like a free therapist or something. People tell me I'm a good listener. I guess I'm just the only one that's willing to listen. It is nice though, having a place to stay at night, I mean. It works out for everyone. I listen to their troubles, they give me a place to sleep. Someone once told me drug dealers are the new bartenders. It's all the same to me. Just a bunch of lonely people trying to find comfort in other lonely people. But not me. I'm good. Everything I need, I have right here in my backpack. Damn, that guy took my last cigarette. Didn't I just buy this pack?
You need one?
Thank you.
You know, today's an important day for me. Just thought I'd share.
Is today a personal holiday or something?
Not yet, I guess.
Did something happen earlier today?
No, it's a pretty normal day.
So then why is it important?
Well, 2 years from today, I think I'm gonna be really happy. I mean, I just think that, but just thinking about it makes me really happy.
I'm not sure I follow.
Well, my sister's supposed to come and live with me, and her paperwork should be approved by then. At least that's what the embassy says. I haven't seen her in years, but she looks so grown in photos.
Where is she now?
Back in China with my grandparents. She's been living there ever since our parents passed away. It's been hard to be away from each other, but I couldn't take care of her and do school at the same time. But now I'm done with school, working full-time, I finally have the time and money to bring her here.
Why can't she come to New York right now?
Well, I was born here in New York, but she wasn't. Our parents had her in China, which was horrible planning on their part, in my opinion, because now I have to deal with all this visa stuff. They really don't make it easy. But the embassy said 2 years from today.
And you trust that?
I don't know, maybe not. Her arrival date got pushed back once before, but who knows anything for sure. If I only got excited about things I knew were going to happen, I think I'd be a pretty sad person.
But you wouldn't be wrong.
Why does that matter?
I don't know. I guess so you don't wait around for something that won't ever come.
Well, what's the alternative? Not hoping anything good to happen ever?
I guess.
No wonder when I see you around, you always seem so lonely.
What do you mean?
I'm not trying to be mean or anything. I just see you at all these parties with all these people, but you look like you could use someone to talk to.
I talk to people all the time. I'm talking to you right now, aren't I?
But do they really listen to you? Can they guess what you're worried about? Do they even know your name? All I'm saying is that it's nice to talk to someone who knows you, really understands you. Have you ever had someone like that?
A long time ago. But they haven't been around for a while, so I forgot what it's like. You do make it sound nice, though. But how do you trust they'll still be there later?
That's pretty funny. My sister used to ask me the same thing when she was little. So I told her if she closed her eyes and wished for something hard enough, when she opened her eyes, that she would be able to see what she saw in her head. You know, like peekaboo.
And that worked?
I mean, she believed it for a bit, but that was just because she would wish for me to come home every day, and it would. But when I came back here, I told her that it might take a little bit longer to get what she wants as she gets older. But I guess that's the only true thing I've told her. Maybe I'm a bad sister. I don't know.
I don't think so.
Even when I lie to her about when she'll see me?
You're not lying. You'll see her soon. 2 years from now, I believe it.
It means a lot. Appreciate it.
Will I see you again?
I hope so.
Stand up and close your eyes.
Why?
Just do it. Don't open them.
Oh.
Fuck. I miss my dog.